Hello everybody, David Beers here, owner of 39 Minute Workout, and today we're talking about the ultimate guide to getting started with kettlebells. I'm going to teach you today how to pick your first set of kettlebells, how to build a complete kettlebell gym for yourself, and then for those of you who are a little more experienced, I'll also talk to you about men and women, what are your goal weights that you're working up to, because there will be some growth from where you start to where you end up, okay? So let's start off with the non-kettlebell stuff right now. I always say to people, I want you to start with five pieces of exercise equipment. Number one is a simple jump rope, very cheap implement to buy. Number two is a BOSU ball. These half dome things, they're awesome. To me, they're, other than the kettlebell, they are priceless in terms of building a gym. All of my clients use them in our local workout program, every single workout. You don't have to get a BOSU, but it opens up a lot of different strength moves and a lot of our calisthenics that we use. So I urge you to get it. You can get one, a non-professional one, for under $100 or right around $100, okay? So that is gonna be your biggest single investment, but to me, they last forever, they pump up easily, they're easy to use, and they open up a ton of different moves. So in terms of the kettlebells, you're gonna want three bells to get started. And most of your workouts, unless you get really strong and you want a lot of different stuff, you'll see my clients using three bells only, okay? So I'll start with women's first. In general, I would say the average woman, when most women walk in here, and I'm talking from the 30s to their 60s, these are the bells we begin them with. Now mine are written in kilos if you can see the numbers through the camera. I'm gonna talk pounds, because most of us here are thinking in terms of pounds. So we start swinging about a 20 or 25 5-pound kettlebell, and we start pressing and rowing with 15-pound kettlebells. So that should be for women, the beginner weights. 15s for presses and rows, 20 to 25 for the swing. If that sounds heavy to you, I promise you it's not. I would say almost nobody who walks in the door that I work with, even up to people in their 70s, even up to people who haven't worked out in 10 to 20 years, this is the right bell to begin with, because as I teach you in the next few videos over the next few days, your legs are what lifts the kettlebells. If you picked up a baby that's that heavy, it's not gonna be too much for you. And if you go too light on the swing, you're gonna cheat and use your arms, which is what we wanna avoid. So 15s, 20 or 25 for the swing, that's your starter bells. For men, men's strength is a little bit all over the place, but I would say the average man, where I want you to begin, is a 35-pound swing weight and about a 25 to a 34 press weights, okay? Now, if you wanna go to a store and check them out, that could be helpful, because you do wanna see, can I take this bell, put it here, and press it up over my head? If it's heavy, that's fine. If it's impossible, like you literally can't push it up, then that's a problem. You need to go 5-10 pounds lighter. You just need to try increments. If you're buying them online, I would trust these numbers, or walk into a gym and grab some dumbbells and see what about can I press overhead that's challenging and I can press maybe 5 times. Okay, that's a good starter bell. So men, about 25s and 35 for the swing, women, 15 and 25. Your goal is going to very much differ on how hard you want to work, how strong you can become, just a lot of factors. What's your age? And it's hard for me to sort of say, well, here's the set number, because I have people up into their 60s who swing 50 and 60 pound kettlebells. I have people in their 40s who don't swing over 35 or 40. So it's not easy for me to say exactly what you should pick, but let's talk about goals. For the average woman from 30s to 60s, I would like you to swing at least 35 pounds eventually, up to maybe 50 pounds, okay? That might sound crazy. I'll show you videos of women in their 50s in my program who easily swing our 50 plus pound kettlebells. So that's like top line, and top line for press weights would probably be about 25 to 30 pounds for women, okay? So for women, again, 25 to 30 pound is your high end goal for presses, and swing somewhere in the 35 to 50 pound swing rate. Okay, for men, again, it wildly ranges. Guys who I work with, I would say your goal is at least 50 pounds for the swing weight, up to 70. I really don't see any earthly reason for going over 70 pounds unless you are a young competitive athlete and you want to be stronger. I've never needed anything more than a 70 to get as strong as I ever wanted. So goal weight for men, 50 to 70 pound swing weight. Press weights, again, they're gonna wildly range at least 35 up to 50 should be your goal press weight. So that's a simple guide to getting started with kettlebells. All you want to write from this video is, where are your starting weights? Unless you've used kettlebells and you know you're stronger than this, these are your good starting weights, okay? Hopefully that was helpful. Up next, we've got kettlebell warm-up coming for you. I'm gonna teach you the kettlebell swing in other videos coming, and then we're gonna do 3 different kettlebell workouts that are great for your first 30 days using kettlebells. Thanks so much, we'll get you next time.